Alright guys, welcome to another amazing edition of Max Stories, where we bring you exceptional individuals who are doing exceptional things in the country. And today we have a very interesting topic we're talking about, and there's no other person to have, you know, to on this show today to better tell us, give us the insight on what we're talking about. We're talking about comedy, right? Comedy, is it a business or just a hobby? Because people see it in, there's this misconception about it. But with me today, I have no other than a brother who has made his mark in the comedy industry and he's still breaking boundaries. The one and only. Kelly Black.
What's up, my brother? How are you? I'm proud of you, man.
My brother, I'm proud of you.
Proud of you.
I remember those days.
Yeah, when you came to my office and said, Kenny Black, this is what I want to do with my career.
Exactly.
And I pushed you and I said, you can do it.
Wow.
I think you should see me on Monday by 12. I need help. You should help me.
So, Kenny Black, you have come so far in your career.
Yeah.
And let us just do a quick run through. Tell us how it started for you.
Okay, I'm Otolori Kende Peter, popularly known as...
In short, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Kenny Black.
So I started comedy 2008. It's been a crazy journey.
Okay.
So you know, starting from the point where nobody wanted to listen to a small boy talking.
Mm.
When they finally wanted to listen to me, they were confused. Is he a musician? Is he a comedian? Because I did music and comedy together at the same time. And it took a while for me to let people understand that this is music comedy. This is a breath of fresh air.
Mm-hmm.
And we started growing gradually. And growing from the street of Ejigbo to traveling around the world, it's not a small something. And I just even got back this morning.
From where?
From the car park. So
from
it's
park.
Yeah, it's a car park, man.
Now, starting for you, you said there was an industry of just stand-up comedy.
Yeah.
Nobody put in music.
Yeah.
So were you not scared getting into that part? And like, okay, if I put music and comedy, would they accept it?
Yeah, I was not scared. I was only worried. I didn't know how long it would take for everyone to accept the genre of comedy I was about doing then.
Mm-hmm.
So it's crazy, but thank God for the likes of the mentors who did music comedy before me. So it was not really hard to venture into the music comedy of the things. One of the reasons why I'm still here is because I always go back to my drawing board and see what I have not done. If I look at what style of music have I not done, then I try to listen to it and do something fresh.
Looking at your comedy empire, I would, let me say that, because you're building a brand that's getting bigger.
Yeah.
At what point did you realize that it wasn't just a hobby anymore, not just having fun? And for Nigeria to get to accept comedy as a profession, it was quite difficult. So at what point for you did you realize that, let me make this a profession, it's not just my hobby anymore?
Okay, it was in two ways. In 2009, I won an award in Ejigbo as best comedian. It was a competition.
Mm-hmm.
And at that point, I started thinking, I think I should take this serious, because I'm receiving an award, means everybody voted for me.
Yes.
And everybody, they are saying that this guy is the person. Not until 2011, I was invited for the Calabar Festival.
Okay.
So I performed at the stadium where everybody was, as in a full stadium, like a football stadium.
Yeah.
I was like, me.
This is looking
so
good.
I entered plane for the first time.
Mm.
As in, it was not bus. Before the record, I entered plane. And that was when I was paid my first big beam.
Big beam. You felt it. Your account knew that something hit it.
It's not even my account, it was my hand.
Your
I received this cash.
Are you serious?
As in, because I didn't know what bank to use, the Water Power Bank or the Kado Bank. But I all packed the money for my hand. I counted this 15 times.
Wow.
Something just struck me like, come on man, you are paid this huge amount for doing something you'd love to do.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you take it serious? Why don't you be create an industry?
Now, looking at comedy in Nigeria, people expect you to be on stage for an hour. Under that pressure, seeing the kind of material you chunk out, it's very tasking, because you get to rehearse music, you get to put stage performance, you get to put other people to synchronize with your performances. How is it for you putting up at least more than an hour every time if you put up a show?
In 2008, 2009, 2010, I had only two jokes.
Hmm.
So I was always remixing the jokes.
Yeah.
Remixing the jokes, and I was trying to get more jokes, but they were not coming. And until I started picking up things around me to crack jokes, and I started picking what material to say at this place.
Mm-hmm.
I will keep some for this place.
For this place,
I'll keep some for this place.
Yeah.
So the day, there was a day I was supposed to perform. So everybody said they were not going on stage. Everybody said they were not going to say that it's not your time, the hall is not full.
Yeah.
So they said, okay, let one upcoming go. And I came, I was, and I did my set. I did like a 15 minutes, and the stage producer just said, continue. I was going on 30 minutes. Continue.
And you were not prepared.
I was not prepared. So I started, the jokes I prepared for this one,
yeah,
because I gathered everything together. And that was how I did the 45 minutes. I was like, wow. The 45 minutes, and big shout out to Ogbolo for, I was not even supposed to perform. It was a Lolo's event. I just came backstage to drop somebody's phone.
Wow.
I went back home and I said to myself, eh?
So you can.
So I did 45 minutes of my own jokes alone.
Yeah.
I started to write more. That if I can do 45 minutes, I can do 44 days. So, yes, I'm fasting. I'm praying. So that was how I started, and I was able to do 1 hour. So,
mm-hmm.
What makes me special is because I'm able to talk at the same time sing. And I realized that if I just talk at the same time sing, it will also be boring at some point. So, I decided to add Broadway into it. So, I decided to do okay. If I talk a little bit, I sing. If I sing at some point, I dance. If I dance at one point, I add drama. If I drama, I come back and add all of them together.
Huh.
So, it's art in its form entirely. Uh-huh. So, I've been able to do that. And by the time I'm done, I realize I've done more than 1 hour.
But now, the question is working with other people and putting them to follow through
the scripts and everything.
How do you manage that?
It's crazy, you know, especially sometimes when you really need somebody to play a role and that person is not in the country.
Yeah.
You have to fly that person from maybe outside the country.
Mm-hmm.
You have to do the hotel. So a lot goes into the production that I do.
Mm-hmm.
A lot goes into getting everybody together and getting people who've not worked together before.
Yeah.
And to do something. But I would thank God for grace and the fact that I think I've gained a respect in the industry that everybody wants to be part of what I do. And like, they know that what you're doing is exceptional. To everyone who's been on my platform, supporting me and coming through, I want to say thank you in advance again for the other ones.
You are a good politician.
That's
in advance for the other ones.
Because everybody have to come here. That's why I've said that. Okay, Black is going to do a comedy show. If everybody come together and show voice came like, I know that. Of course, as you can see, I've lost weight. I've been working hard. Huh? I'm not even on IG yet. So.
come on. Okay, so now let's just quickly talk about your international comedy shows. And everything. How has it been? Looking at Nigerian audience and the foreign audience.
Yeah.
How is it for you?
Yeah, it was crazy. First time I got to London, I was scared of what to say. I said this was like 3-4 years ago. I was scared of what to say. I was like, hey, would these people laugh at
that?
Do they understand our pigeon?
They
I realized that they like intelligent jokes.
Yeah.
So I composed my first white audience joke and I said, I don't like falling in love in Nigeria because falling in love in Nigeria is crazy. You know, when you fall in love here, you guys are like, I like the way you guys fall in love here. I watch a lot of your movies, High School Musical, you know. Yeah, you walk in the classroom, you hit the girl, the book falls down, you look, pick it up, and that's love at first sight. But in Lagos, it's different. You have to buy pizza, do their Uber, do their hair, and before they think about the relationship.
Huh.
And, you know, I know I'm not Kevin now, but I like to think like him. So I got them there.
And I
said, you know, I met a girl on the flight. I didn't want to talk to her.
Mm-hmm.
But my menu failed her. I was about picking the menu. She was about picking the menu. So I looked at her. She looked at me. And we fell in love. That was love at first sight. We didn't say a word to each other.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, as we were about landing, the pilot said, cabin crew, prepare for landing. So the guest said to me, excuse me, sir, can you tell me who sang the song?
Mm.
I said, okay. When she gave me the earpiece, what I heard was, although we've come to the end of the road.
Yeah.
They were singing with me.
Wow.
And I can't let. I was singing while singing with me. Let me compose the song. Because this is just a boy, not two men. So it's a natural.
Yes, yes.
You belong to me. I belong to you. And I said, boys to me. I said, well, so my name is Kenny Black. I'm a music comedian from Nigeria, from Africa. I would like to meet you. She looked at me and was like, America. I said, what do you call America? Concerned. I said, America. I said, forget America. I'm Nigerian. Nigerians can get married to Americans. We can come together and be.
Yeah.
She said, America. I said, forget America. I insulted this girl, gave her the worst insult of her life. And I guess that's the reason I'm still single, because I jumped into conclusion. I even broke my leg some days ago for jumping into conclusion. And I got to, the lady was about picking her bag. And this was the punchline. The lady was about picking her bag. And because I insulted her so much, she couldn't talk to me. And I saw her mom running to her shouting, Erica. And that was when the thing struck me. That I jumped into conclusion. If I had chilled, I would have understood the fact that the girl actually told me her name. She didn't say America.
Oh.
She said, I'm Erica.
And wow.
And I got a standing ovation from them.
That is intelligent.
You know, it took them like 3 seconds to get it.
I said,
it's quite good. It's funny. It's funny. One more. I said, that's all.
I've been wanting to ask you about your show, you know, The Oxymoron. And okay. I realized that it's a series. The one you're doing now is the third edition. Tell us what to expect for this last one, this next one coming up.
Okay, one thing about The Oxymoron is that the only competition I have in The Oxymoron, it's me, myself.
Yeah.
I always want to do something better than what I've done before.
Okay.
So it's not been easy. You know, your Oxymoron is done in July, and in December you're already planning for the next one.
Mm.
So we did the first one, which is The X-Files, Kenny Black showing the extraordinary things in him.
Mm-hmm.
Then we did the second one, which is The Rush, and why I'm still single, why I don't want to be rushed, why I don't want to rush into things, and why we don't need to take a lot of things to rush into things.
Yeah.
So this time around, we're doing top 10, we're playing with the number 3. Talking about 3, a lot of things about 3, you know. I remember when growing up, our parents used to tell us, for example, they called you, Eddie, how many times did they call you?
3 times.
You know, yeah, that kind of point. Even our dead body in Nollywood, they don't answer until the third time. So like, you just hear, Oh, go, the guy there, oh, went into the first 2 times. So I'm running to a lot of three things. I'm talking about, you know, secondary school, third term.
Yeah.
I'm talking about politicians, third term. Yeah. I'm talking, so the show is the third edition, so expect nothing but the very best of 3.
The best of 3.
You see the musician, the comedian, and the music comedian.
Makes sense. Okay, so we'll be looking forward to that.
I'll be looking forward
to that. And we're hoping that you are going to blow our minds away again.
I swear, I'll blow your minds away, I promise.
All right, man, thanks for talking to us on the show today.
Thank you very much.
We appreciate you. Nice shoes, by the way.
Our former president had no shoes, so I needed to.
I'm tired of you. Yeah. All right, guys, so well, this is where we call it Raps and Mac Stories. Like I said, we always bring exceptional people, and we just spoke to the exceptional Kenny Black on comedy and its ups and downs. But hey, it's good to be successful at what you do. And like you said, passion first before you think about the money, right? So if they don't pay you now for a show, you would still stand.
All right, I think we are done.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.